Hello amazing people, Pete Moriarty here. This is a very important video today, sharing with you a massive change to Google's branding and a lot of other plan details for what was Google G Suite is now Google Workspaces, or Google Workspace. And so I'm just getting used to the name, as you can see. We are going to jump into some details on what the plan changes are, what Google's philosophy is with the change, what's kind of some of the driving forces behind it for them, how work is changing. And if you're currently a subscriber to Google's productivity suite, then this is going to be an important one for you to check out. I need to give you a bit of a caveat before I get started, and that is that we've just been given this information literally hot off the press from Google. And so what that means is if some of the information that I share is not perfect, or if it changes in the next couple of days or a week, please forgive me. So what I'm sharing today is going to be for guidance only. Of course, before you enter into any agreements or change your plan or anything like that, you should definitely consult with a professional, make sure that you're getting exactly what you're expecting, and you can reach out to our team if you'd like any help with that. So this is Google Workspace, and we are going to take you through exactly what you need to know about all the new app and how it works and the new branding and new logos and stuff like that, but really what the new strategy means for Google with their workplace collaboration tools. If you don't know who we are a small business consultancy. We help small and medium-sized business owners and even large organizations with their technology. We want to help get businesses in flow, get their tech running smoothly, and we use a tool called the Growth Roadmap for that. What that means is that in each stage of business, you'll have different challenges with technology, you'll have different challenges with managing your team, and we know the order that businesses go through and where you should be putting your attention. We know what boxes you've got to tick based on what stage of business you're at, because if you're in business and you're flying blind and you're trying to do all of the tech things at once, you'll find that it very quickly gets overwhelming. And so for us, what we want to do is make sure that you put the right things in place now as you're a business growing and scaling so that you don't run into problems later. And what kind of problems can you run into? Well, if you are investing in expensive infrastructure, or maybe you have security breaches that can cause problems, or you've got a business partner who disappears and takes files from you, any of those kind of risks that can happen in a business if you don't put the right technology strategies in place, we want to help you avoid those. So if you haven't already checked out some of our other videos on the Growth Roadmap, head along to our YouTube channel. We got heaps of stuff on there, and that'll share with you and guide you in the right direction on building a technology strategy inside the business and developing yourself as a strong technology leader. But today we're talking about Google Workspace, and we're talking about Google's rebrand and relaunch of their tools and what Google are doing about that. First up, I want to talk a little bit about, kind of what's changing in the landscape of work. Obviously, at the time of recording this video, many people are working at home. This year, COVID has come upon us, and many have been forced to work from home. And what that's meant is many have had to change the way that they've been working, from coming into an office every day to working remotely. Now, for our business, we've been working remotely for about 6 years, so it's not news to us to work remotely. Our team are all geographically distributed. We all primarily work from home, or from co-working spaces from different places or all around. And it's been pretty natural to us. It's also pretty natural to Google internally. They are a business that have been designed from the ground up for flexible work. Even though they certainly have offices all around the world, they've been a really, really big purveyor of flexible workplaces. And we have learned from Google, working in close proximity to them, and learned the ways of working productively at home. Now, the rest of the world has kind of been forced into this. Even though we've been saying for years that remote is the new way of working, everyone's been forced into this and has had to learn how to actually get things to work. And back in April this year, we did a whole series, an 8-week series for our members in our concierge program, telling them all of the secrets and everything that we have learned in running a remote business for nearly 10 years now. So if you haven't already checked that out, that might be one to check out. Head along to itgenius.com, have a chat to the team to get access to that. Now, we're going to be talking about how work is changing, and interestingly, up to 48% of respondents in a recent survey, I can't remember who the survey was from, but up to 48% of recent respondents actually said that after COVID, they would not want to go back to only office-based work. They would want to have the flexibility to work remotely. And I would say it's probably going to be a higher number than that. We're already in the day and age where people are using their mobile phones for work, while you're commuting on the way to the office. People are kind of already checking in on emails and starting to work on documents with Google's collaboration suite. makes it nice and easy. If you're already using all the Google format documents for your business, it makes it pretty straightforward to work from an iPad or work from a mobile device, makes it super simple. So there's some of the real big shifts and changes that are happening currently in the landscape. And I've got a couple more interesting stats for you. Number two, interesting statistic, is that 1 in 4 workers right now also primary caregivers. Let that sink in. 1 in 4 workers are also primary caregivers. And what that means is that for employees that are stuck at home on lockdown, which in some parts of Australia, that's a whole state of Victoria currently, people are literally having to look after their kids, potentially have their kids do some kind of school, or maybe they're not old enough for school, they've got to look after them, while working at the same time. And so they have to take advantage of remote collaboration tools, Google obviously being one of those that is a very effective tool at helping people to work remotely. Number three, statistic, that right now, 1 in 3 workers, 1 in 3 colleagues is feeling disconnected from the human element and the human touch of working in a workplace with their colleagues. And so connection and collaboration and people not only just working together literally, but feeling like they're working together has never been more important. So these are pretty interesting. I'm curious to hear what you think about those. Maybe drop down in the comments below this video. Let me know what you think about those statistics. I found them pretty interesting. And I think now is the time for all business owners to get really smart about making sure that your team are well, protected and well supported in the way that they're working, particularly around their family arrangements, but also making sure we're actually using the tools that we have. And if you've not already checked out the other videos on our channel, we have heaps of resources on how to use G Suite effectively. And we also have a G Suite Getting Started course, which is free if you transfer your licenses into our billing with IT Genius. Again, contact our team if you're interested in that. Now, Google's big idea with Google Workspaces is, Google Workspace, I'm still getting used to the name, flexible, helpful, simple. Flexible, helpful, simple. Now, we already know Google's tools are pretty darn flexible. They work across multiple devices. They work across multiple operating systems. They're basically designed to work across multiple platforms, even though you will still have some people who might be using Microsoft-based documents and emailing them to you every now and again. Google will let you edit them inside of Google Drive in the Chrome browser, even save them into your Google Drive. You can't collaborate in real time or anything like that, but you can still work with those kind of documents. And that's one of the things that I really love about Google is that flexibility, is that, okay, if someone sends you a PDF, you can convert that to a Google Doc, and it will actually take the text out and convert it to a Google Doc. If you're working with Microsoft documents, you can still work with them and even send them back in a Microsoft format if you really wanted to. Of course, the preference would be to switch them over to Google format and share it that way. Number two is helpful. And what I really love about Google's focus on being helpful is how deep they've gone into their AI efforts. Having suggested responses inside of email, inside of chat, inside a Google Sheet, you've got the Insights tab, and that's going to automatically pop up and show you things like suggested graphs or data analysis, or it can even do an AI-driven, a pivot table. And so you've got all of those options that are AI-driven, basically just baked into Google's technology, making your day easier. Absolutely love that. Google even have said to us that over 20% of all emails, over 20% of all emails across Google's platform are now written at least in part by AI, either using the auto compose feature, which finishes sentences for you, or the suggested responses down the bottom of emails. And that's really phenomenal. Think about how much time you spend on email each week. For some people, it might be 5 or 10 hours a week, and Google are able to help you save that time up to 20% potentially for each person. That's pretty damn awesome. That could be hours a week back in your pocket. Now, number three is simple, and Google's focus has always been simple. They've been criticized for being overly simple, but I really like the minimalist approach of Google, because for me, it means that I can just focus on getting my work done. I don't have to worry about the bells and the whistles and having a million different buttons, but not being sure how to use them. It's a little bit like the difference between a gasoline-based car and a Tesla. In a Tesla, it's got autopilot, it's got auto steer, there's no, electrical system or cooling system or oil or, service changes or anything like that you need to do. It's just got 4 wheels, big battery, couple of electric motors, and that's about it. I think they've got less than 50 moving parts in total. And that's what I like about Google, is that focus on simplicity. For me, myself, I run a team of over 40 employees in our business. And if we were trying to worry about training someone on how to use all 300 buttons inside of Microsoft Word just to get their work done, I'd actually just prefer them to focus on getting the result with a more simple tool rather than overcomplicating things. So that's one of the big things that I really, really appreciate about Google. So what's their future strategy? Well, Google are really focusing on their unified experience. And so you would have seen changes inside of your Gmail with Google including chat inside Gmail now, Google Now including, you know, your other plugins inside of Gmail. So third-party apps, if you're using something like Copper CRM, it'll just appear on the sideline there inside your Gmail. And they're going even further with that unified experience by actually even bringing in things like documents now. And so you can see here, there's a document being created from a chat room. And then when someone clicks onto that document, it's actually going to open and allow you to work on the document literally inside the Gmail window, which is pretty darn cool. So yeah, unified experiences like that are coming more and more to Google. I'm not really a fan of spending all day long in Gmail. I've got another video that I recorded on what tool I use to hide my inbox and only get to my emails when I want to, rather than being distracted by them all day long, because that's not great for productivity. But I am loving that Google are bringing all their tools into one tab, because usually I've got six tabs open. I've got Mail, I've got Calendar, I've got Chat, I've got Google Drive, and now it's actually like those first three have automatically been consolidated down into one now that my Calendar and my Chat are both inside the Gmail tab.